In this video, at long last, we will see a proof that the fundamental group of the circle is the integers. I want to start by introducing a family of loops, one loop for each integer. So given an integer n, I'm going to write down delta n of t, and that will be the loop e to the 2 pi I n t. That's the loop that wraps n times anti-clockwise around the circle, starting at 1. Here's the circle, here's 1 in the complex numbers. In particular, if n is negative, this winds clockwise around instead. So the way I want to proceed is to write down a homomorphism f from the integers to the fundamental group of the circle based at the point 1. This is going to be the map that sends n to the homotopy class of delta n. So we need to check this is a homomorphism. We also need to check that f is injective and that f is surjective. And that'll tell us what we need to know, that it's actually an isomorphism. So let's start by proving it's a homomorphism. First thing to check is that the identity goes to the identity. The identity in the integers is 0. That goes to the homotopy class of delta 0, and delta 0 of t is e to the 0, which is 1. So this is the constant path, constant loop, which is exactly the identity in pi 1. More non-trivially, we need to check that f respects the product. So if I do delta m, concatenate that with delta n, what I get should be homotopic to delta m plus n. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to let delta n tilde be the unique lift of delta n to the covering space of the circle by the real numbers. So what is this map P, this covering map? It's the thing that sends x to e to the ix. So in other words, I'm finding a logarithm for my path delta. So delta of n of t is e to the I delta tilde n of t. And I can do this, and it's unique, provided I tell you where to start. So I haven't given you a starting point, but such that delta n tilde of 0 is 0. I have to give you an initial condition to give a unique lift. Okay, then let delta m tilde be the unique lift of delta n, delta m to the same covering space with delta m tilde at 0 equal to, well, I don't want 0 anymore, I want it to be wherever this path ends up at time 1, so that I can concatenate them. So now, the claim is delta m dot delta n is, exp I delta m tilde dot delta n tilde. In other words, the concatenation of these lifts upstairs is a lift of delta m concatenated with delta n. Finally, I want one more lift. Let delta m plus n, the m plus n tilde, be the unique lift. Of, surprise, surprise, delta m plus n with initial point 0. So what we know is then delta m plus n is exp of I delta tilde m plus n. That's what it means to be a lift. Now if you don't like exp I blah blah, you can just say this is P compose this concatenation. And this is P composed delta tilde m plus n. Right, so I want to draw a picture now where it's a graph. In this direction we have the variable t. In this vertical direction, we have the real line. So this is going to be, you know, delta tilde is going to be drawn in this direction, whatever index we want to put on it. So first of all, here's the graph of delta tilde m plus n. So we know explicitly what this is. Delta m plus n tilde of t is just 2 pi m plus n t. Let's whiz back and see why. Well, it's the thing you have to put inside the exponential to get delta m plus n, which is exactly this, 2 pi n t, and where n is m plus n. Okay, so here's t equals 1, here's t equals 0, here's the height 2. I'll move this little r. So this is the height 2 pi m plus n. And in between the graph is just a straight line. This is the graph of delta tilde m plus n. This concatenation, very similar, it's now going to be a piecewise linear functional. Right, so for time half, you're going to do a straight line with slope 2 pi m. I mean, slope, yeah, I'm only going half the distance, so maybe the slope has to be half that. So maybe I'll just say what height it gets up to. It gets up to height 2 pi m. And, or is it 2 pi n? Which way am I concatenating? I'm doing delta n first, sorry. So this is 2 pi n. And then I do another straight line until I get up to m plus n. So this piecewise linear thing I'm drawing here is, so the previous one was this left-hand line. This one is the graph of delta m dot delta n with tildes over them. And now the claim is these paths are clearly homotopic, right? They have endpoints fixed, same endpoints here and here, and in the plane they're just homotopic. I can just vertically homotope from this piecewise linear guy to this fully linear guy. So R2 is simply connected. So delta tilde m plus n is homotopic to delta tilde m dot delta tilde n. And that tells us just by now composing with P, that these two guys are holotopic. And this is delta M plus N. And this is the concatenation. Okay, so this proves F is a holomorphism. Okay, let's whiz up to the top and see what we need to do next. We need to prove that F is injective. And because F is a holomorphism, what we need to check is that N in the kernel of F implies N equals zero. Right, so it's enough to prove this. Okay, so if N is in the kernel of F, that means delta N is holotopic to the constant loop. So we want to prove that for each N, delta N is not holotopic to the constant loop unless N is zero. And the way we're going to do that is we will show that for a suitable covering space, the monodromy around delta N is non-trivial. So what covering space are we going to use? We're going to use this one that we saw in the previous example. So this is the reals. I'm thinking of it as like a helix over the circle. So this map is x goes to e to the I x. And you can see at least delta 1, the monodromy takes this point around up the helix to the next point up, and then around the helix to the next point up. So let P of x be e to the I x. So P is a covering space of the circle by the reals. P inverse of 1 is the set of all numbers which are multiples of 2 pi, integer multiples of 2 pi. Those are the ones that exponentiate to the identity. And sigma delta n, you can just check. If I apply it to 2 pi k, what I get is 2 pi k plus n. Why is this? Well, delta n tilde, the lift of delta n starting at k, is exactly 2 pi k plus 2 pi n t. I claim that if you exponentiate this, what you get is delta n. Let's see. Exp I delta n tilde t. This is p of delta n tilde of t. Is e to the I 2 pi k, that's the identity, times e to the 2 pi n t I. And that is delta n t. So this is a lift of delta n that starts at 2 pi k. So at time 1, I get 2 pi k plus 2 pi n, or 2 pi k plus n, and if you remember, how did we define the monodromy? It was exactly the time 1 point of the lift that started at k. Okay, this is non-trivial. So this is a non-trivial permutation of this set, as long as n is non-zero. because it translates by 2 pi n. Finally, we want to check that f is surjective. So, given a loop, gamma in S1 based at 1, I want to find an n such that delta n is homotopic to gamma. So the way I'm going to work is I'm going to take the same covering space. So this is, again, this map x goes to e to the ix. This has appeared in all parts of the proof. This is a really important covering map. It's called the universal covering map in this case. So we're going to take this covering map and I'm going to lift gamma to some gamma tilde in R such that gamma tilde of 0 is 0. What does that mean? I.e., I'm finding a logarithm for gamma. So if I do gamma of t, that's the same as doing exp I gamma tilde of t. I can do that by path lifting. I find a unique gamma tilde. And I'm going to say that if n equals gamma tilde at 1 divided by 2 pi, then delta n is homotopic to gamma. This is the claim. Right, what's this? Well, gamma tilde of 1 is in the set 2 pi times the integers because this is p inverse of 1 and gamma is a loop. So that's giving me an integer. Let me draw the graph of gamma tilde. This is the t-axis, this is r going up here. Here's 0 where gamma tilde starts. Here's 1 at time 1. Gamma tilde of 1 is a height 2 pi n, and in between it can do whatever it likes. It's just the graph of some function that I'm drawing. This is the graph of gamma tilde. But what does the graph of delta n tilde look like? In other words, the lift of delta n that starts at 0 looks like that. It's a straight line. And now, just like before, these two paths are homotopic in the plane. Homotopic rel endpoints. In fact, you know, not even just rel endpoints, but you know, as graphs, I can just move this one down or up, depending on which side of this graph it's on, just linearly, until it agrees with this graph. I get just a sort of straight line vertical homotopy between gamma tilde and delta n tilde. So that implies that exp I delta n tilde is homotopic to exp I gamma tilde. Just by composing the homotopy, whatever homotopy this is, if we call it H, with the projection map P. Right, P is this map. P of x is e to the ix. But this is delta n and this is gamma. So we found an n such that delta n is homotopic to gamma. So that shows F is surjective. Hooray! We have seen that the fundamental group of the circle is the integers, and that the loops that correspond to the integers n are the ones that are homotopic to this delta n that winds n times around. So we finally got to the point where we understand what the fundamental group has to do with the classical notion of winding numbers.